No matter what the critics say, audiences are proving that they're always up for seeing Jennifer Garner take down some bad guys. Peppermint premiered on Netflix on December 1st, 2020. And although the film received heavy criticism upon its release in 2018, subscribers are now diving in to see it for themselves. Just one day following its release, the thriller ranked in the top 10 US films streaming on the platform. In Peppermint, Garner stars as Riley North, a widowed mother seeking revenge against a cartel that killed her mechanic husband, Chris, and their 10-year-old daughter. Leaving behind her life as a Los Angeles banker, North spends years in hiding as she prepares to avenge her family's murder.
What do I want? I want justice.
From there, Peppermint becomes a pretty standard action-packed revenge story. Critics slam the movie for relying on outdated stereotypes, dreary visuals, and what some claim to be a direct-to-video feel. Combined with the familiarity of the subject matter, the poor critical reception may be why Peppermint didn't make a huge splash when it was released. However, most critics acknowledged Garner's solid performance in the otherwise lackluster film. Scott Marks of the San Diego Reader openly speculated that Garner must have only taken the role for the money, saying, "Why else would she agree to lend her name to what is essentially gun porn?" Other critics panned the film for perpetuating racist rhetoric. For instance, The New Yorker's film critic Richard Brody wrote, "Peppermint is a racist film that reflects the current strain of anti-immigrant politics and its paranoid focus on MS-13. It would be better for the world at large if this movie hadn't been made." But general audiences sometimes have different opinions than critics do. Peppermint scored a 12% on Rotten Tomatoes among registered critics, but holds steady among everyday viewers with an audience score of 71%. Additionally, Peppermint was a modest financial success, making more money than it cost by landing a worldwide box office gross of $53.9 million. Now, 2 years after its theatrical release, Peppermint has found new life on Netflix, with Garner proving that audiences will happily watch her kick butt any day of the week. Musing on the film's streaming success, Forbes critic Scott Mendelson wrote, "Ironically, the film's muddy visuals makes it look less like a glossy Hollywood flick and more like a straight-to-VOD action movie, the kind of which are currently doing quite well by Netflix." Whatever the reason for Peppermint's renewed popularity, the film's surprise resurgence could even pave the way for a sequel. While revenge flicks might seem like the perfect recipe for a one-and-done story, Peppermint may be the exception to the norm. Back when the film first released in 2018, there was already some talk that it could follow the road of director Pierre Morel's Taken series. Shauna Duggins, Jennifer Garner's longtime stunt double, went on the record back when Peppermint first premiered in theaters with her hopes that the thriller might eventually earn multiple sequels. Speaking to Variety, Duggins said, "Don't we all dream that it can be a franchise? Absolutely. I mean, look at Taken. It was phenomenal. And then they did two more. Jen can pull it off, obviously." Garner has certainly proven her ability as an action star, but Duggins believes her appeal goes far beyond her ability to throw punches, saying, "What makes Garner a phenomenal actress is you can see her in these beautiful love stories and comedies, and then she can step right into a revenge movie like Peppermint. She's not just out killing people. You feel every bit of her anguish, her physical pain and her emotional pain, and that's why the audience is rooting for her. You want her to win." And while Peppermint struggled with controversy, a sequel could hypothetically take the parts of the movie that audiences did respond to and move away from the more troubling aspects. So far, none of the other cast and crew besides Duggins have opened up about sequel possibilities. But with the movie returning to headlines, speculation is growing fast. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.